lost our way. We hopelessly lost our way. You are where we praise. You are where we love. You give the healing and grace. Our hearts always hunger.
Hello and welcome to our 10 Days of Prayer 2022 Children's Programme. Do you know that prayer can change many things and that over the years God has performed so many miracles for us? Can you think of something that God has done for you that has changed as a result of prayer? Do you know, boys and girls, that God is crying out for a changing world? The Bible has so many promises that testify to this. For example, in the book of Jeremiah 29th chapter, verse 13, God says, "And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart." And in the book of Joel, God says, "And anyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved." "Draw near to God and he will draw near to you," says the book of James, 4th chapter and verse 8. At this point, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our main speakers to you for this week, DeAndre Joda and Michael Gordon, both from the Aylesbury Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Hello there, my good friends. I'm at the beach. It's very hot at the moment, just enjoying the sun. I may be in a dress shirt, but I just came for a South morning stroll to look at God's great creation and look at nature. And I wanted to talk to you about the theme today, and it is the urgency of prayer. The scripture reading for the urgency of prayer is, "How much more will your Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" which is taken from Luke 11 verse 13. Well, why do we need the urgency to pray? Well, we want this to reach this world with the good news of the gospel and Jesus' soon return. There are 548 cities in the world with a population of a million or more. We want to share all of the gospel and salvation with them. We need the power of the Holy Spirit to reach millions of children and adults in the big cities. Millions are dying without knowing Jesus loves them and will come again the second time. Jesus promises to give us the Holy Spirit, regardless of age or race.
whisper a prayer in the morning, whisper a prayer at noon, whisper a prayer in the evening, so keep your heart in tune. God answers prayers in the morning, God answers prayers at noon, God answers prayers in the evening, so keep your heart in tune. Jesus may come in the morning, Jesus may come at noon, Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your heart in tune.
Prayer suggestions. So on this first of our 10 days of prayer, under the topic, the urgency of prayer, when you kneel to pray, thank Jesus for loving us so much, more than anyone else in this world, and ask him to restore and heal us and transform us. Thank Jesus for the promise of the Holy Spirit, and ask him to allow the Holy Spirit to live in our hearts, and so that we can glorify him. And in doing so, we can ask the Holy Spirit to clear out of our lives anything that is not of God, so that we can give ourselves fully to Jesus. And ask the Holy Spirit to baptize us and our church with the Holy Spirit, so that we can bring millions of people in our schools and our neighborhoods and our cities to the gospel.
Seek his face.
Spring.
Merciful and loving Father, as I come before you humbly today, dear Lord, I come claiming the promise of Luke 11:13, dear Lord. Dear Lord, I pray and I ask that you grant your Holy Spirit upon all the churches, dear Lord, so that we could go into the world and preach to the big cities, dear Lord, your gospel, so that millions of lives can be saved and they can all come to know you as Jesus Christ, dear Lord and Savior. Dear Lord, I ask that you guide and protect each and every one of us, dear Lord. Grant us the strength that we need to carry out your message. In your name I pray. Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you so much for all the blessings you've given us, and I thank you for all the times in the past that you've given us your Holy Spirit. I thank you for the message that you gave us in Luke 11:13, where you told us that if we ask of you, you'll give us your Holy Spirit. I pray that you'll help us to be witnesses for you and to spread the good news of the gospel to people that are not as fortunate as us and don't know it. I thank you so much for everything you do, and I pray that you'll use your Holy Spirit to intervene in our lives and help us to do better things for you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
The army of Judah was paralyzed by fear. As we heard a mighty multitude, we quickly draw in near. But as they prayed for
activity. For today's prayer activity, we will focus on prayer rocks, supplies. You will need small rocks enough to carry in your pocket and a permanent marker. With a marker pen, write your name and the name of one city you want to pray for. Then, when you see your friends at church or school, you can exchange rocks. They carry rocks around with them, and whenever they take it out, pray for the name of the person on the rock and the city on it, so that many cities will get to hear about Jesus. Keep exchanging rocks with someone else each week. You can get your friends at school involved, and this will be a great way to start a rock ministry and share with your faith with others in your class and school.